Hallo allemaal, welkom bij Dutch & Go. Today we're going to continue our very serious talk about negation and how to use it correctly in Dutch. In a previous video, I already referred to the word geen and explained to you how to use it and giving you hopefully some useful examples. And in this video, I'll be talking about the word niet, how to use it correctly and how to position it correctly. And I'll be giving you some useful tips throughout as well. Let's go! So in the previous video, I explained to you how to use geen, okay, which is used with whenever we want to negate an indefinite substantive, okay, whether countable or uncountable, okay. Niet would be used in all of the other cases, so that's actually quite straightforward. You just have to imagine that geen and indefinite words attract each other like a magnet, okay. So that means that unless there's an indefinite word in the sentence, it's definitely niet. Okay, we can define the position of niet by three criteria, using three rules basically. I know that you might have learned this differently in school with many other rules that they've thrown into the mix. I actually managed to simplify it and just reduce it to three rules with which you'll be able to negate, let's say, 80 to maybe even 85% of the sentences in Dutch. The 15 other percent, I would just say, like, you'll learn as you go along, but for A1, A2 students, these three rules should actually suffice to be able to, well, use niet correctly for 85% of your sentences either way. So, you know, that's kind of cool. So with regards to the position of niet, okay, it's actually quite easy because the three rules are always, it's always before. So niet comes always before a certain sentence parts, okay? Let's look at the first one. First of all, before adjective or adverb, okay? So adjective says something about the quality of our substantive, so they can be colors, flavors, you know, the, for example, whether something is interesting, interessant, mooi, emotioneel, lekker, saai, etc., okay? Or adverbs, which will define our verb, so the qualities of our verb. For example, the frequency, using frequency words like vaak, altijd, nooit, or for example, the intensity, the preference of that verb. So for example, a word like graag, okay? So now let's look at some examples how that would play out in real life. The film is leuk. The film is niet leuk. Wij kijken graag naar soaps. Wij kijken niet graag naar soaps. Mijn vader is intelligent. Jouw vader is niet intelligent. Ik vind dit boek interessant. Ik vind dat boek niet interessant. Okay, so that was the first rule, before adjective, before adverb. Let's look at the second rule, before preposition. So prepositions are those elements in the sentence that will define either the position of certain things, so op, onder, naast, okay, or that will express a relationship of a substantive with a verb. So for example, naar, naar de bioscoop gaan, naar een film kijken, okay, bij een bedrijf werken. Prepositions are always combined with substantives, okay? You have to imagine it's like, you know, prepositions are the cute little puppies of the Dutch sentence. So you basically never leave a puppy alone. You know, so never leave your preposition unattended by a substantive, right? Right. So let's look at some examples. Wij kijken naar een film. Wij kijken niet naar een film. Ik woon in België. Ik woon niet in Brazilië. Mijn vriendin komt uit Duitsland. Ik kom niet uit Duitsland. Ik hou van donkere chocolade. Ik hou niet van witte chocolade. That was the second rule. In case we have sentences where we don't have an adjective or adverb and don't have a preposition, okay, then we would use this third rule, which is before eindgroep. Remember that other video that I made about eindgroep? Well, this is going to come in real handy now. So as we've seen then, okay, the eindgroep can consist of three elements, either the separable element of separable verbs, infinitives, or the participle of the present perfect tense. So let's look at some examples. So in some cases, the eindgroep will be empty will be void. But it's basically like a room in a house that is always there. It's just that sometimes there's nobody in the room, okay? So, first of all, ik heb het boek. Here we don't have an eindgroep. We don't have an infinitive or participle or anything like that at the end. So, in this case, the niet goes at the end of the sentence. Ik heb het boek niet. Ik hoor jou. Ik hoor jou niet. Hij helpt mij. Hij helpt mij niet. All of these sentences don't have prepositions, don't have adjectives or adverbs. So in this case, niet goes at the end of the sentence, technically before eindgroep. This rule before eindgroep always applies because as soon as I bring out the eindgroep, the niet will appear before it. So for example, ik heb het boek niet. Okay? Yeah? Ik wil het boek niet hebben. Right? So that's why this rule before eindgroep makes everything so much easier with regards to the position of niet. Let's look at some other examples. Ik wil de telefoon kopen. Ik wil de telefoon niet kopen. Hij kan me helpen. Jij kan me niet helpen. Zij moeten het huis verkopen. Zij willen het huis niet verkopen. And now, for example, the eindgroep where it's the participle, present perfect. It's the same rule. So this makes your life so much easier because it's basically all in the same rule. You don't have to relearn the negation rules when you're doing the present perfect. Same rule applies. Ik heb het boek gekocht. Ik heb het boek niet gekocht. Ik heb mijn telefoon gevonden. Ik heb mijn telefoon niet gevonden. Zij heeft dat gezegd. Zij heeft dat niet gezegd. Okay, so those are the three rules for how to position niet correctly in the Dutch sentence. So either it's before adjective or adverb, before preposition, and if we don't have adjective, adverb, or preposition, it's before eindgroep. Okay, those are the three rules for how to use niet correctly. My final tip for you is use the position of niet correctly and, well, basically use your intuition. So let's look at some sentences where there might be some confusion on where to position niet. Zij gaat vaak naar de gym. So if you wanted to make that sentence negatively, incorrect would be zij gaat vaak niet naar de gym, because then you're saying she goes often not to the gym. Like, you know, even in English, that doesn't make a lot of sense. So the correct negation of the sentence would be zij gaat niet vaak naar de gym. Not often, okay? She doesn't go often to the gym, yeah? Or another sentence, wij gaan met vrienden naar de bioscoop. Here we have two elements of the sentence that have a preposition, okay? So then you have to think logically about what it is that you want to negate, okay? It wouldn't be super logical to say, wij gaan met vrienden niet naar de bioscoop. You're going with friends, not to the cinema. Like, again, like, okay, nice that you're going with friends, but then why would you specifically say that you're not going to the cinema? Like, that's not logical. So better would be, we gaan niet met vrienden naar de bioscoop, and then you just negate the whole action of the whole sentence, okay? Does that make sense? Like, then you just put it in front of the preposition met, okay? We gaan niet met vrienden naar de bioscoop, and then you've negated both prepositions. Finally, also these rules that I've just given you for how to use niet correctly in the sentence and position it correctly, they also apply to short little words like ook, works exactly the same way. Ik woon in België, zij woont ook in België. Ik ben intelligent, jij bent ook intelligent. Ik heb het boek ook. Same rules. And the same thing goes for like other words like al, nog, and wel, okay? So with these rules, you can basically use a lot of these smaller words that might end up tripping you up in your construction and basically simplify your life quite a bit. So thanks so much for watching. This was my video on how to use the negation correctly. Let me know in the comment box down below if you have any other questions or any particular issues. I'll also be uploading two other videos, exemplary videos, where you can see how to use niet in some two very funny concrete case studies as well. I hope you found this video was interesting. Check out my blog as well, because there's always new grammar tips and content on there. And see you next time on Dutch & Go. Tot de volgende keer bij Dutch & Go. Dankjewel voor het kijken. Dag!